and welcome. You're watching Agenda on NDTV 24/7. I'm Kajari Sen, and today we're going to be talking about the role that NRIs, non-resident Indians, the Indian diaspora, plays in the electoral process. We saw with the Aam Aadmi Party's rise to power, a lot of people who left the country coming into politics, becoming a part of the larger game. We know that there are friends of the BJP and friends of the Congress in various places like England and the United States of America. But there seems to be a real push to get them on board for the 2014 Lok Sabha polls. And the question that we're asking here is why? How important is it for NRIs to be a part of the electoral process in India? And we've got our guests joining us. Joining us from the BJP, Lalita Kumaramangalam, and joining us from the Congress, Priyanka Chaturvedi, which very neatly segues into our first talking point of the day. And the question that we're asking is there an increased focus on NRI participation? Let's go over to Lalita Kumaramangalam first. Lalita, you know, we saw that huge summit which took place yesterday. There were all the top brass of the BJP there, and a clear message was being sent to the NRI community that they would in fact do whatever it took if they came into power to give the NRI community what they wanted, including as far as investment is concerned, voting patterns are concerned. Why this push? Why these promises?
See, first of all, I'd like to point out that the BJP has been engaging with NRIs far longer than even the Congress has had its Pravasya Divas annually. We have had FNRIs, that is friends of the BJP, friends who are in all countries in the world, not just London and the US. They come in from Kuala Lumpur, they come in from Singapore, they come in from various countries around the world. We've always paid them attention. We've always said that the NRI contribution, especially to the economic growth of this country, is very important. Perhaps this may have been one of the first times when this summit was held in the country, in Delhi. Now, obviously, we are heading towards elections, and every single vote counts. This is not a new initiative or effort or reaching out by the BJP. We have always respected the NRI contribution, and we continue to respect it. Obviously, since it's in Delhi and we are heading towards elections, all our senior leaders were present. We have also pushed for postal ballots for NRIs because we feel that it's very difficult for them to travel back to India to vote every time a general election is held. Also, we have said that we are going to provide conditions favorable to NRIs so that their contribution in FDI can go up. Currently, it's just around 10 to 12%. We want to tap what goodwill they have for their own country, their mother country, economically too, and see that their investment increases. If their investment increases, obviously their say, in, especially in economic matters, is going to increase. But I want to re-emphasize that this is not a new initiative of the BJP. It's not that we are scared of the AAP. When any party is going to be facing polls, facing elections, we know very well that every vote counts. NRIs are permitted a vote, and of course we are going to woo them to vote for us.
Now, of course, every vote counts. And yeah, there's no debate that there has been an engagement with the NRI community, both from the BJP and from the Congress. You know, we just heard Lalita talk about the Pravasi Devas. Priyanka, you know, we just saw that take place as well. But there's been an interesting difference in the approach that has been that the Congress has had towards the NRI community as compared to the BJP. It's been more muted and more sort of sympathetic to the Indian sort of the Indian diaspora is less relevant, almost it seems sometimes, to the Congress discourse.
No, I would beg to differ where this is concerned, simply because you know, as the party at the center and you know, who's forming the who's in the government, we have managed to address a lot of issues that concern the non-resident Indians. And yes, there has been an increasing participation as far as NRIs are concerned, with social media platforms and people being able to, you know, start a narrative, start a discussion, we feel more involved.
Right.
And so we also see the same change, and it is quite encouraging to see that even NRIs are equally feeling interested in how the politics works in India.
I think,
and
Priyanka,
are being more participative.
You've brought up an important point that I'm going to toss that over to Lalita as well. That is also the second talking point that we're going to be looking at, which is, has social media made the entire you know, the engagement of the NRI community much, much more accessible. Lalita?
It's not a question of acceptable. It's made it much more easy.
Accessible. I said accessible.
I mean, I'm saying this repeatedly, that the BJP has always supported NRIs, and NRIs have in turn also supported us. But yes, the rise and the growth of the social media has made contacting people who are not in our immediate vicinity, which obviously includes NRIs also, much, much easier and much more, I think, open.
But does it also, Priyanka, raise the question of them being much more critical? Because when you've got social media, when you've got sort of 24/7 satellite news channels or that they can track, do you think NRIs now are much more aware of the issues at home than they were, say, 10 years ago?
No, absolutely. Social media, in terms of NRI participation, has played a very crucial role where they participate a lot more than ever before, and their views are also heard more than ever before. So I wouldn't say that, you know, social media has not been very important. It has been, as far as NRIs are concerned. And the increased participation that you see in the entire political narrative comes from there. But yes, there are a few drawbacks where they do try to, you know, change a narrative or try to believe or make, you know, through their ideas or whatever, try to change the narrative in the country. So, I mean, it's all a matter of participation. You see them participating, you see them giving their point of view, trying to address, you know, share their concerns with regards to everything. So, yes, it has made them more participative, and social media has played a very important role.
Munish Rezada joins us now, Aam Aadmi Party member from the United States of America. He's with us on Skype, so let's quickly go over to him as well. Munish, at this point in the conversation, we're talking about how much how much engagement has increased as far as social media is concerned, which makes the political situation and the ground realities in India more accessible to the NRI community. What's your take on that?
Yes, I will totally agree with you on this. Social media has intensified the participation and the involvement of the global community. The global community, Indians sitting across the world, have always felt connected to the motherland, and social media has just boosted that up. You know, whenever you talk to them, whenever you engage with them, you will see that they have much more knowledge. And I'm saying it out of my experience. The level of the in-depth understanding of Indian politics which they have, the update, you know, about Indian events going on, social issues or political issues, is remarkable. And Aam Aadmi Party has been amply benefited with this. You know, whenever you talk to them, you're right. Just amazed by the level of information they have about the political events. Yes. Right.